All right, so Smitty, we're checking out the Jilang LIGO 78X Pro 2-inch Cinewhip. And this one, actually, there's several different variations of their this kind of newer model that they've come out with. This one here is the DJI version with the Caddx Polar camera. So mine actually, as you can see here, does not have the Polar camera. They sent this to me here without the Vista Air unit, which is on the bottom, and the camera, and I just had to add that myself. Obviously, a lot of the vendors are having a hard time sourcing DJI components, so even getting these out to reviewers is difficult. So I did have to add that myself. I just added the, basically, it's pretty easy to do. I just took these four screws off, and then there's a spot there specifically for the Vista, and I just soldered on the four wires for the Vista. This has a separate receiver, so I just four wires for the Vista and then attached the antenna. And then this one came with this third-party FreeSky D16 receiver. It's not an XM Plus, although on Banggood they list it as an XM Plus. It is, I don't know who makes it, honestly. I thought it would maybe Radio Master or something like that, but I think they've sourced this from some other vendor. It works similarly to an XM Plus. When you power up, you hold down the bind button and it goes into bind mode, and you just bind it in D16 mode, and it seems to work like an XM Plus receiver. So yeah, that's what I flew it on. This one has just a single antenna here, not a dual antenna, and so I just routed through these little channels here in the front and the back, which is okay because on the bottom, so it doesn't get into the way of the props. But you know, obviously you're gonna have yours pre-built with the DJI system already in there, and you'll have the Caddx Polar camera. So I already did a video review on the Caddx Polar, so I'm not going to be covering this camera itself. You've seen footage of that already. Just come with several different mounts here that attach to this mount that goes onto the main frame, and they've done the smart thing here with this sort of vibration dampening for the HD camera, and so whatever you put in here is not going to get a lot of noise or jello from the motors and the props. And this is kind of an interesting design, really different from a lot of the other ones that I've seen out there. Reminds me a little bit of the Cine 8 from Happy Model, the analog DIY build-it-yourself kit. Kind of similar in that sense, but this is obviously digital. They have this sort of duct system here. I think on the Happy Model it's like 3D printed perhaps, and they have this foam on the outside, but the kind of, this, it's a little bit different. It's not the same. Like the foam here has these little stands, see these little screws that go into a piece of plastic that sticks out the other side. And that screws into that, and then the foam goes onto these little standoffs, little plastic standoffs that are part of this duct system. And you can see it's not like attached with like adhesive, so there's a little bit of give here. So obviously for indoor use, you know, for bumping off of stuff, furniture, whatever, so you don't want to, if you don't want to damage it, this is going to be good for indoor use, that kind of thing. Or if you're going to be bouncing off something and you don't want to leave marks on the walls, this will be good for that. And it's not going to just fall off because the adhesive wore out. It's actually screwed into the frame. And then to give this plastic, which is injection molded plastic, by the way, to give this plastic duct system slash frame some stiffness, they've added some carbon pieces here that attach to the motors. So this attaches to the frame, and then this attaches to the motor. So this, basically the motors aren't flopping around. That's on one on this side over here, and then one over on this side. But they're not attached to each other or the center piece here. This carbon bottom piece here that you land on screws into the injection molded plastic as well. And then on the top, you have another carbon piece here. A little standoff there. This is for the battery area. Your all-in-one flight controller goes here, and you see the USB port is inverted, so the board's inverted, and that sticks up. And there's some foam here, so the battery doesn't dig into it, so I didn't have any problems with that. And then, of course, you get your battery strap and XT30 connector here. But yeah, all these little screws that you see all over the place are going into this plastic piece, you know, is like they're self-tapping screws. So in a pretty bad crash, you're probably going to strip out, and then you're going to have some issues where you're going to probably have to use some glue or something like that. There are some extra side pieces here, some carbon side pieces to give it a little bit more stiffness if you want. Those are optional. That's what these holes are for. If you want to install those are also included in the kit. But I wanted to keep the weight low, and I didn't think it was going to make that much difference in terms of performance. Seemed fairly stiff already, but if you want a little bit more protection and a little bit more stiffness, there's some carbon pieces you can screw into these side holes as well if you want to. So in terms of specs, 1204, 5,000 kV motors. You want to run this on some sort of a 4S battery. I flew it on a 4650. The all-in-one flight controller board there is a 12-amp F4 flight controller, 12-amp VSCs, PLLES. And of course, you get your Cadex Vista on the bottom and that Free Sky receiver on the bottom. So that's pretty much it in terms of the specs and everything. It's about the same weight as a lot of the other 2-inch Cinewebs out there. So this one here is coming in with a little camera mount here. It's coming in at 104 grams. For comparison, here's the Alpha 85 from iFlight. I removed the camera mount, so keep that in mind. It's a little bit heavier, 106.7, so you probably add about another 5-6 grams for that little camera mount. But this has a Vista. This actually has the Nebula Pro camera, 2-inch props, but this is 1303 motors. And so this is more like the design that you see on a lot of other 2-inch Cinewebs. It's more like this. And of course, you don't have any of the foam padding on the outside for this. So that's a little bit different design here on this model. So the footage you're going to see here is from the Firefly X. And I already did a video review on this one as well. I was originally trying to use the Gyroflow program to use the black box data. This flight controller does have 8 megabytes of black box available to stabilize the footage, but then I realized, and you've probably already seen that video from last week, that the movements of the camera need to match up with the gyro or the flight controller. But because of the dampening here, this camera is allowed to move around, which is good because you don't want jello to go into the camera, but because that movement is different from the movement of the gyro, obviously you can see here this moves, but the flight controller is not moving at all. You can't use that gyro data to stabilize this footage. Now, the manufacturer of this camera, I've asked them to export their gyro data as a separate file with the video file, as a CSV file, so you can use it with Gyroflow. But they have not responded with that request. I don't know if they're going to do that or not. This camera has a gyro, so it can do electronic image stabilization. So there's no reason they can't export that gyro data for use with Gyroflow. So hopefully in a future firmware update, they'll do that for this camera. But right now, it's not able to do that. So I just stabilized the footage like I did the last time in the original video on the Firefly X. Just used Warp Stabilizer in Adobe Premiere. It's just video editing stabilization for the footage. You know, it's okay. You know, obviously you can put a naked GoPro on here and use Real Steadigo and get much better footage, of course. They did include this little plug here, which is meant for this Firefly X camera. So you'll see photos of this with this Firefly X camera. And they also had another plug for a naked GoPro, but it's for their specific naked GoPro case and BEC. It was a different plug that's not compatible with the Beta FPV one, so that's why I didn't use any of my GoPros on this one. And this one here, this little plug here only outputs 5 volts. This is, they wired them both up, and I actually removed the one for the naked GoPro because it wasn't going to work with any of my naked GoPros. The naked GoPro plug is actually soldered to the battery lead, whereas this is soldered onto the 5 volt BEC on the flight controller. So yeah, this one, once you put the camera in here, this will just plug in and power the Firefly X. So if you have this Cinewebs and this camera, they'll work all together like this, but then you'll need to stabilize your footage using some sort of video editing software. Right now it does not work with Gyroflow or Real Steadigo or anything like that. So you have to use some sort of video editor to stabilize your footage. Okay, so that's going to do it for this one. Links down in the video description if you want to check out this model. And, yeah, here's the footage from the Firefly X. Talk to you later.